Yes, so we are back and we are going to create a macro from scratch. Basically, we are not going to use record macro feature and we are going to write a small code. So first of all, we'll insert a module as we have done how to do it. Now we can write the codes on the right. So this is our VB editor, which I've already opened. This is the view Microsoft Excel, which is the Excel view, and you can go back to the Excel view, you can come back to the VB editor. Now, as we have discussed, we'll write our codes in separate modules. So let's insert. Either you can right click over here, click on insert and go to the module option, or simply here you can see insert user form option. Beside that, there is a drop down. Just click on that drop down and get the option of module. So click on this module and a coding screen appears. So basically you can adjust the size of this coding screen by just clicking on the resize button. You can adjust the size of the coding screen. It's entirely up to you. You can resize the editor as well. So keeping my coding screen like this for you all to understand. This is where I will do my coding. This is where I'll start my coding. Before that, it is essential that we rename our module. So you can rename it as my first code. My first code. So this is my first code which I am going to write over here. And then we have to add more modules, right click anywhere on the Project Explorer. So yeah, this is my first code, this is my first module. As you all can see, the name has already changed. It was earlier module 1, the name has changed to the name of my workbook is mydemo.xlsm, which I showed you all how I saved using the macro feature and .xlsm feature. This is mydemo.xlsm, which is the name of my workbook. And then this is the name of the module where I'll write my first code, which is my first code is the name of the module which I have given. To insert more modules, simply right click, insert module, and you'll get separate module. And you can see this is the new module which has cropped up and the name is module 1. Again, I can change the name of this. For now, let's concentrate on our first code module. Then we have double click anywhere on the module, double click any of the module in which you want to work, and the name appears on the top and a coding screen appears. Expand the module, resize it as well. So we have done all that. Now we will start with our basic coding. So this is my VB editor. This is my first module which I made. I changed the name to my first code. Now when you start writing a code, it's very important to understand that this is not case sensitive. You will learn gradually that why I'm saying this, not case sensitive. Case sensitive meaning whether you use caps lock, whether you don't use caps lock, it doesn't matter much over here. Now the next thing which I'm going to teach you all is that I've taught you all in Excel class that what are the cell ranges. So this is cell A1. This entire thing is a cell range starting from A1. And how you can denote this particular cell range? It starts from A1, it ends at E9. So this particular range can be written as A1 to E9. This is how I rename a cell range. You might have used a lot of formulas, functions where we have selected a number of cells, we have selected a particular cell range. So in that case, it is represented like this. This is an entire cell range. Why I'm showing you this? Because it is important for our first code. I'll start with writing sub space. You start your code, any of your code, by writing this word, which is sub. The next thing you give is your coding is the name which you're going to give to your code. So each code, maybe one code performs one action, the other code performs other action. So you're going to give a particular name to all of your codes. Like you have name for a Excel workbook, like you have name for your module. Similarly, in a module, maybe you having two or three other codes, separate codes, and each code should have its own name. So let's suppose I'll give the name as, you can write it as code 1. Just click on enter and see what has happened. Sub, it has changed to blue. End sub, which has already automatically, which has come up, and the brackets. So what are the new things which have come up? I had written this in small letters, so it has changed itself to a capital letter S. Brackets have cropped up itself, and a line called end sub has come up by itself. So this is how, just by writing sub, I've written the name, and just click on enter, and you get all these things, and you can write your code. You can just by clicking enter, I can change the width between this, and I can write my code lines over here. So this is how you start writing a code. The brackets which have cropped up are for we want to enter argument in our macro. So this is basically what we want to enter an argument in our code. I'll show you all how this happens. The first code which I am going to write is range. This is my first code, range. As I showed you all what a range is, range, I'll open bracket. So these are the cell 1, cell 2 as a range. Let's write it as A1. You can make it small or you can use capital letters, but don't forget to use quotations. I need to use quotations. So this is how I've written range A1. Now range A1, this is cell A1, should contain, let's suppose, a value of 56. This is my first code which I've written. The moment I click anywhere, it gets automatically changed to a capital R. So it doesn't matter at all. And basically this line signifies that the range cell A1 should contain the value of 56. And how to run this now? There are two-three ways. There are many ways to run a code. For time being, we'll just concentrate on one thing. As you all can see an option here of run sub user form. Just click on this and your code will be performed. And see, once I hit run, here is this cell has been populated with 56. The cell A1 has been populated with 56. This is how you have written your first code. So congratulations to you all. We have started our coding and we have written our first code, and we are finding it really, really interesting. So we have done the range command to execute. We know how to execute it. The other way you can execute the same is, let's use another way of clicking. As you can see, the shortcut key is F5. So let me erase this first. Alt F11 is for the Visual Basic Editor. Don't forget the shortcuts. I'll click on F5 and see, my code has been executed. So this is very interesting on how you learn, on how you have created your first code. I hope you have enjoyed this. Now this slide is very interesting. Basically we'll go on to detail later on. Run macro. So these are the three buttons which you can see over here. I'll resize this. Yeah. So this is the run macro option which we used currently to run this particular macro. Break macro or to debug the macro. We learn what this debugging is. Basically you divide, this is only a one line code which you have written. Maybe you have 4-5 lines in your code, so you want to just go into line by line, go inside and go outside of the, basically we say go inside and go outside of the code. So when you want to go inside and outside of the different lines, then you use this debug macro, which is over here. Once you click on this, then your macro has been broken and you can simply go inside and outside this particular thing. So this happens, and then is the reset to come out of the macro code. This is jumping in, basically break a macro. As you can see, this has changed into break. To debug a macro, you jump into the macro, and to come out of it, you click on reset option and you have come out of your macro. Now what is the feature of these two? We'll learn later on. This is jumping inside the macro, basically breaking your macro. This is coming out of it, that is resetting your macro and coming out of your macro code. So these are the three buttons. We'll learn about this fourth button in the later classes.